salute, man. Nigga, he gotta be up here. He just wanna be up here too. Look at him. He can't help it. Go on. Hey, a quick little message to everybody, but specifically to Errol Spence, the truth, Errol Spence Jr. Still a hot topic, right? You damned if you do, and if you damned if you don't. That's something that everybody already know. I'm preaching to the choir. I ain't saying nothing slick to a can of oil. I already know this. But it's on my mind. You know what I'm saying? It's my nocturnal thought. You damned if you do, and you damned if you don't. You damned. The hell on. I'm like, I'm looking at it like, man, it ain't nothing new underneath the sun. This shit is all just repeat. You know what I'm saying? Recycle, fucking rewash and repeat, rinse and repeat. That's all this shit is, every day, all day, from the beginning to the fucking infinity. You know what I'm saying? But I'm looking at Errol Spence and his current situation and what it is. And it just got me thinking, you know, hanging out with rappers and shit. I was watching a little bit of He Knows His Sports the other day. He was like, you know, you can't be hanging out with this Yellow Beezy because rapper's lifestyle be on some bullshit and some fuck shit. And I mainly been watching a whole lot of scrapbook boxing. Salute. Go subscribe. I don't know how in the fuck a channel like that only got 2,000 subscribers and there's other channels out here that's fugazi than a motherfucker that got like 20 and 30 and 40,000. This motherfucker scrapbook boxing should be up there with the 50,000 subscribers. Blood boxing. I've been binge watching some blood boxing. So I'm going to sprinkle in a little bit of blood boxing on this video too, then I'm going to get the fuck out the way. Look, nothing new underneath the sun. Hanging out with rappers when you a boxer. First person I thought of was Mike Tyson. Hanging out with Tupac. Next thing you know, Mike Tyson is incarcerated. You know what I'm saying? Is locked up. Then I'm thinking of Floyd Money Mayweather. Hanging out with 50 Cent. Next thing you know, Floyd Money Mayweather is incarcerated. Adrian Broner is hanging out with all the damn rappers. He trying to be a rapper. He hanging out with Lil Wayne and T.I. and Soulja Boy. Tell him. He keep going to jail. I'm just saying, Errol Spence is hanging out with Yellow Beezy. Is that a wise decision? Because I ain't gonna judge you, my guy, my dude, you know what I'm saying? One of my favorite boxers. I'm not gonna judge you. Now, Jeff, I'm not gonna judge the people you surround yourself with. You dig? To each is his own. I don't condemn, I don't condone. But is the lifestyle, is it, you know what I'm saying, healthy for fighters, you know what I'm saying, destiny? Like, what role you gonna put that shit on? And I'm talking to myself too, as far as just my life, man. I don't want to end up incarcerated. I can make one wrong move, you know what I'm saying? I could be straight as a fucking arrow, like Bloodsport. I could be a straight up choir boy. It don't matter, man. One false move, one wrong turn, and I could fuck up my whole life. Everybody, anybody could. You dig? It don't take but a second. So I'm saying, wising up, is you wising up? You know, is you wising up? And is this whole recycle situation with an athlete hanging out with a boxer? Like, you know what I'm saying? The rappers always wanted to be boxers. Boxers wanted to be rappers. And, you know what I'm saying? Artists wanted. You see what I'm saying? Like, Tupac used to hang out with Mike Tyson because they supposed to have been like kindred souls. Like, Tupac was just a small Mike Tyson, and Mike Tyson was just a big Tupac. And Floyd Money Mayweather, he said he hung out with 50 Cent because he had that one friend that he knew was around him that didn't just need him because of his money and fame. Look how that shit turned out, how their relationship turned out. You know what I'm saying? I don't know why AB hung out with all. AB was trying to be a rapper. He coming out with his own album, you know what I'm saying, still adjusting to fame or something like that. But I'm saying this to Errol Spence because I think dude is a solid dude. You know what I'm saying? And I hate to see him make mistakes that are going to be crucial to what's going to happen to him in the next 5 years. When he had that accident, it already was like, man, that shit was cold. You know what I mean? You don't want to see that. I didn't want to see that. And he came back, and he came back strong. But the thing is, man, it ain't nothing to relapse. It ain't nothing to backslide. It ain't nothing to get real comfortable again. Like, you know, you puking up your fucking guts because you done drunk too much, and you praying to God, please, please, God, I'll never drink again. And then what happened after you get that out your system and you start feeling better and your body start to get strong again, your mind start to get weak again? You start having to go right back to that same situation, back on your knees praying, God, God, look, you got to end up in a damn jail cell. Because I don't wish that on no man. I do wish that on some men. I ain't going to say no names, but you know who I'm talking about. You dig? But I'm not going to wish that on just anybody to be put in a damn, you know what I'm saying, a small box. You know, you're going to have to end up with that picture that you took, you know what I'm saying, when you were scarred up and everything from your accident, how easy that could have. And then I'm looking at you with the, I think some people was, because I couldn't, I don't go into that. I mean, I was posting pictures of him where, you know what I'm saying, they taking the record of people that get booked. Look, man, I'm just saying, you got the potential to be great. You got the potential to do whatever you want to do, however you want to do. And to be honest with you, the moral of this story is, you're damned if you don't, and you're damned if you do. You know what I'm saying? I was watching some blood boxing, and he tripped me out, like I said, because people talking about the hanging with his friends and wearing skinny jeans. And I'm listening to Blood the other day. He was going on some, I was actually on his like retro boxing. He was talking about one of them old school heavyweight dudes, man, was walking around with like $400,000 on his neck and was carrying a little purse. You know who I'm talking about, Blood. Do me a favor, Blood, man, because I really appreciate Blood. To me, is a straight up OG. And I feel like, man, he take the time and stop by on a little platform like mine and leave a comment. He don't have to do that. That shit let me know that is a solid, solid dude. You dig what I'm saying? And I do appreciate that, man, 100. Do me a favor if you get the chance, man, because you know you the historian. I'm not the historian. I'm trying to catch up with, well, I'm doing this scrapbook. I'm trying to binge that. But anyways, to cut this video short, let me know if you can, you know what I'm saying, just give me a few more old school boxers that was hanging out with the, you know what I'm saying, the rapper or the musician, the you know what I'm saying, whatever era of musician that was hot at the time, you know what I'm saying, in the 80s and the 90s and all that. What boxers were hanging out with, and did they end up in the same situation? Because all I could think of was three: Tyson, Mayweather, and AB. But I know there's some more out there, and I know that you know. But anyways, man, like I said, this video ain't gonna be long. Just wanted to get that off my mind. Nothing is new underneath the sun. It's all the same thing. I mean, you really damned if you do, and you damned if you don't. But I would rather see you try to put your best foot forward, and I would hate to see you keep making the same mistakes over and over and over again. They get worse and worse and worse consequences. You know what I'm saying? Like, the accident was bad. You know, the little dancing video, that's cool. You're hanging out with your friends, you're having a good time. The little, you know what I'm saying, hugging, kissing on your boy, I mean, that's your boy, man. Who am I to judge? That's not my style. I wouldn't recommend it, but that's neither here nor is it there. But I'm just saying, is that relationship, is that friendship going to keep putting you in jeopardizing situations? You know what I'm saying? Would that put you in a situation where you might get incarcerated? I would hate to see that, bro. I think you wiser, smarter than that. And man, ain't nothing wrong with loving your brother from a distance. You dig what I'm saying? Peace out, man. It's Nocturnal Thoughts. I'm gone. Holla at me, Blood. Let me know. And I appreciate you, man. I appreciate you dropping by the channel and leaving comments, man. That's for real. I salute that, bro. I know I respect it on a high, high level. And scrapbook boxing, hey, man, I appreciate the knowledge. You know what I'm saying? Because people can hold that shit hostage and sit on that shit. And I can tell he just been collecting for years and his whole life. And it's like, dude, put that shit on YouTube and I can just go straight to it. Hey, man. Salute. I just want you to